This time, ChargerLab got a 140W GaN 6-in-1 desktop charger from Litno, and it's only $40.99. Different from other chargers, it is equipped with a power cord, 3 replaceable AC plugs, and a display. To know how it achieves so many functions, let's take it apart and check its internal structure. First, remove the plastic film. The Litno logo and product appearance are printed on the box. We can see 3 different kinds of plugs. There are 2 images on the back showing how to replace the plugs and charge 6 devices at the same time. Open the box. It contains plugs, a charger, a cable, and a power cord. The dual USB-C cable adopts a braided design. The connector has an uneven surface for easy handling. Its length is about 1 meter. ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows it has an eMarker chip and supports PD3.1 USB 2.0. The power cord has a clever design. One end can be slid into the charger itself, and the other end can be replaced by different plugs from different countries. And there is a slide button marked with push for quick release. Its length is about 1.56 meters. The grooves of other 2 replaceable plugs can be easily slid into the power cord. The EU plug is pre-installed on the charger. The black case is made of fire retardant PC, and the Litno logo, 140W and GaN are printed on the front. The specs in film are printed on the back. It can support input of 100-240V, 50 or 6 turns, 2.5A. The total power is 140W. It supports multi-port outputs and automatic power distribution, and it has passed CE and FCC certification. The input end of the charger has the same slide button as the power cord for easy separation. It has 3 blue USB-C and 3 orange USB-A ports. The display above the ports can show the real-time charging power of each port. Here is the power button. The size is about 112x90x35mm, and the weight is about 270 grams. The ChargerLab Power ZKM003C shows that the USB-C 1 supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, 5, SFCP, PD 3.0, PPS, DCP, and Apple 2.4M protocols. It has 5 fixed PDLs of 5V, 9V, 12V, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The supported protocols and PDLs of USB-C 2 and C3 are the same as the USB-C 1. So the performance of these 3 USB-C ports is the same. The USB-A 1 supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC 3.0, SFCP, DCP, and Apple 2.4M protocols. The supported protocols of USB-A 2 and A3 are the same as the USB-A 1. Next, let's take it apart. Remove the upper cover with a spudger and hammer. Take out the PCBA module. There are several heat sinks on the PCBA module. The display and sockets are on the small PCB at the output end. The MOS control chip, capacitor, and optocoupler are on the back. ChargerLab found it adopts a secure flyback topology with synchronous rectification and fixed voltage output. Next, take a look at each component, starting from the input end. The specification of the input fuse is 5A 250V. The primary MOSFET and bridge rectifier are on this heatsink. The specs of the bridge rectifier is 1000V 10A, and the NTC thermistor is used to suppress the surge current when powering on. 2 electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are under this heatsink. They are from KSC, 400V, 100μF for each. Next, let's take a look at the primary side. The MOS control chip for QR topology is from Meraki and is optimized for PD fast charging. It supports a wide VCC range of 9V to 90V. It can also cover the PD-PPS output range from 3.3 volts to 23V. The filter capacitor that powers the MOS control chip is from Quaker, 50V, 10μF. The GaN FET is from Core Energy and adopts TO220 package, 650V, 110mA. These two sampling resistors are used to detect the current of primary side, 250 mA for each. The transformer adopts PQ3220 magnetic core and is insulated by tape. The SMD Y capacitor is from TRX. This blue Y capacitor is from NDF. The optocoupler is from OR and is used for output voltage feedback. Now let's take a look at the secondary side. The synchronous rectifier controller is from Meraki. It can be used in flyback topology and is compatible with CCM, DCM, and QR modes. It adopts Meraki self-powering technology to power VCC, and there's no external auxiliary winding required. The synchronous rectifier is from Leitag and adopts TO220 package. These two solid capacitors for output filtering are from ST-E2 series, 1000 microfarad, 25 volts for each. These two electrolytic capacitors for input filtering are from Quaker, 100 microfarad, 35 volts for each. Next, let's take a look at the small PCB we mentioned before. An MCU, 6 USB sockets, and a VBUS MOSFET are on the front of it. 3 buck protocol chips and a VBUS MOSFET are on the back. These 3 buck protocol chips for 3 USB-C ports are from iSmartware with high integration. They support multiple protocols and dual port independent current limiting. They can also be used in fast charging of any USB-C and USB-A ports. The buck protocol chip of the USB-A is the same as that of the USB-C, though 6 synchronous buck MOSFETs are used for 3 USB-C ports. They're from AGM Semi and adopt DFN 5x6 package, 30 volts, 2.7 mA for each. 2 synchronous buck MOSFETs for USB-A are from All Power and adopt a PPAK 3x3 package, 30 volts, 4.2 mA for each. These 4 buck inductors correspond to 4 buck circuits, respectively. These 4 solid capacitors for output filtering are from ST-E2 series. They correspond to 4 output circuits, 330 microfarad, 25 volts for each. The dual VBUS MOSFET on the front is marked with 3810. The other VBUS MOSFET on the back is the same as the previous one. 3 USB-C sockets are blue. 3 USB-A sockets are orange, and they have widened pins for high current. The 8-bit MCU used to control the display and power distribution is from ChipC. It integrates 12-bit ADC and has I2C, UART port, and SPI. Well, those are all components of this charger. The detachable power cord allows you to use it on the desktop or carry it out. And the replaceable plugs are helpful when you travel to different countries. It also has a display to check the real-time power. We found it adopts 4 buck circuits corresponding to 6 ports. Most of the internal components come from lesser known manufacturers, so it's cheaper. Still, each USB-C port can output 100 watts, so if you need a cost-effective charger that can charge multiple devices at high power, you can consider it. Okay, that's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye!